Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Over the last couple months, I have fallen absolutely in love with using these blanks right here. You can get these at the big box store. They cost about, I don't know, 12 bucks each, and they're awesome. They are 18 inches in diameter. They're about 1 inch thick, and they are as true as they come. They are incredibly flat. They're not warped, they're not twisted. And this stuff, I'm not quite sure what this is. It might be like a southern yellow pine, but it cuts incredibly easy on the CNC and it doesn't flake up. You don't get any kind of burrs down in like your 60 degree V carves. These things are awesome, but they pose one major problem, and that's finding center. So in this video, I'm going to show you four different ways to find dead center of this blank. So the easiest way for me to show this to you is to bring you guys in close. So I'm going to bring you in for a bird's eye view. All right, now that we're set up here, I'm going to ask you guys a quick question. Visually, which of these two look better? A, which is this one here, or B, this one here? I'm sure all of you said A, and that's because the graining and the seams of your joints is horizontal left to right. That's very important when you cut these. So that goes for any of these processes here, is you want to make sure that your board, once you find your center, once you set up your file, is running in this parallel direction. The easiest way to do that is you turn your blank on its side and you can see the joints. So there's an easy joint to see there. There's a joint there and a joint there. So you take advantage of the grid pattern on your spoil board, and then you just line up the seam with one of your lines on the right side, and then come over here to the left side and do the same. And now you know that your board is set up correctly, and when you carve it and when you cut it, and this goes up on a wall or wherever it's going to be, it's going to look correct visually because of the way the grain is. So process number one. Now that you are familiar with these joint lines here and you've already identified them, basically what you're going to do is you're going to measure the length of this joint and divide it in half. And then you're just going to draw a perpendicular line from there. So you take a ruler or a yardstick, whatever you use to measure. Set it on one side there, set it on the other side there, and I've got 16 inches. Half of 16 is 8. Put a little tick mark there at 8. And so then you can just hold your straight edge right there. And I have one of these drafting squares right here. These things are really cheap and easy. I'll leave a link in the description. You just register that against your straight edge. Come up to your line right there and then just draw a line perpendicular to that line. So now with that line, we found the center left to right. Now we just need to find the center in this direction as well. So just take your straight edge. You want to line it up with that line so that you know you are dead center of your blank. Make sure you're lined up on the bottom. Make sure you're lined up on the top. I've got 17 and a half. Half of 17 and a half is 8 3/4. Put a tick mark there. And there is your exact center. That's going to be your dead center of your board, just like that. So now as long as you set this up correctly in this direction here, and you bring your router over to this point right here, and you set your X, Y, 0 there, and then you Z off the top of your material, you'll be good to go. Process number two, you're going to use the same concept as you did with process one. You're going to create a straight line, divide that line by two, and draw a perpendicular line from that line. So you take your straight edge again, you line it up wherever you want on the outside of this circle, and then you can take this edge here, and you can just rotate it to where you get a nice even number divisible by two. In this case, it's 14. So half of 14 is 7. So just draw a straight line right there and put a tick mark right on the 7. Register that against your straight edge just like that. line your corner up with your pencil mark that you made earlier, and then just continue this line roughly as far as you want, wherever you think just about past halfway is. So that's that one right there. So now you need to do this one more time. So you can take a smaller ruler if you want, it doesn't matter. So this one is 12 inches, so I got this lined up on zero right there. And I will just bring this edge down till it hits the 12. Half of 12 is 6. So we draw a straight line right there. We can put a tick mark on 6. If you have your ruler to the outside of your line, then you can use your ruler or straight edge as a straight edge guide. And then you just set your drafting square right on there. Go up to your pencil line and you can draw a line. And then you can see right where those two lines intersect, that's your dead center. If you really want to be accurate with this, you can do it a third time, but your third line will definitely go right through there, right through that intersection. Process number three, you're going to take a straight edge like this, a 90 degree stop fence, and you're going to clamp this down to your work surface, and then you're just going to register your blank against that. So I've got one of these 90 degree stop fences clamped into my work surface here. Got this through the T-track. And now that this is clamped down, and you just take your blank and you're gonna slide it into that corner there. And now basically what you did is you took a line, you continued it over in this direction, and then a line continued it over into this direction. And now you found your bottom left XY0. So when you set your file up, you would just set it to run from XY0. This blank right here is about, I don't know, 17 and a quarter, 17 and a half inches. So when you set your file up, you will just set your file up as a square. Then you will just place you whatever you want to cut, whatever you want to make right there in the dead center. And when you bring your router over, set it to there. XY0 here. Set your Z0 off of that. And you're good to go. So once you have your jig set up, all you have to do is set up your file correctly. As you can see, I've got my material set up here for 17 and a quarter by 17 and a quarter. And that's this box here. And then the circle here, that indicates that actual blank. So you can see I'm running my file from lower left corner. And then basically you have your jig that is set up just like this on your work surface. So as you can see, you set your XY0 there. You can bring in your file, whatever you have right there. And then you just run your file from there. Now the final and easiest way to do this is you cut yourself a jig that looks just like this. So the CNC is just running some through holes here, some quarter inch for those nylon bolts. It's going to cut out this middle one. There's going to be two pieces that look just like that. This one here is going to have a recess for the hex head. It's going to sit through the bottom. This final piece is the same thing as the 90 degree stops, except this one's going to have another board reference point at 45 degrees. So what this jig does is it's same as the jig before, except it has another piece here that is off on a 45 degree from each of these. And then you just set this on your blank wherever you want it. Make sure that it's registered in this direction like this. And then you just draw a straight line. Rotate your board, straight line. Rotate your board, straight line, and you're done. There's no math involved. There's no drawing of anything else. And as you can see, right where those intersect, there's your dead center. Once you have your center mark figured out, all you need to do is set your file up correctly. You've got your round circle here. This indicates your blank. Then you've got your design right there in the center. As long as you highlight everything and you come right over to here and you have your center set for 0, 0, you would then set your router right at the point right there in the middle. Right there, and then you would set your XY0 right there. Run your file as is, you'll get perfect results. There you have it, my four easy ways to find center of one of these blanks. And this works for any sort of circle you're trying to find center of. The two easiest ways by far are the 90 degree stop fence. You just have to adjust how you set your file up. Again, you would run it from lower left corner. And then by far the absolute easiest is the jig. You just set this on there, draw your straight lines, and you're good to go. Then you can run your file from actual center, whichever you prefer. If you guys feel like I earned it, please hit that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up. And until next time, take it easy.